Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you happen to be new, hello. I'm so glad you decided to stop by. My name is Dana. If you decide you like what you see and you want to hang out for a bit longer, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Today's video is going to be talking about five newer slash newish palettes. I would say pretty new minus maybe like one, I think is getting close to like 2 months old, but still fairly new in the makeup game. So I thought maybe we could change it up a little bit and kind of dedicate a video to five palettes with just quick reviews and swatches, my overall thoughts, rather than dedicating one video to one whole palette. I have been using all of these, most of them for 2 weeks, one maybe about like 1 week. I feel like that's a fair shot and time period to kind of like gauge my thoughts. So let's go ahead and start off with the palette that I have on my eyes right now. And this is the priciest one in the group. This one retails for $65. You can purchase this at Sephora or Sephora.com. It is the Huda Beauty Rose Gold Palette Remastered. I wanna say the original palette came out definitely over a year ago, maybe 2 years. Time has been flying by, I'm not even quite sure, but basically you just need to know there was an original version of this. It was totally hyped up on Instagram, but since they have reformulated a lot of the shades, I know before a lot of the complaints were about the top row for the foiled shadows. Even whenever you look at this in the palette now, it's a totally different texture than before. This is the palette that I have on my eyes now, and I love it. The second I opened it, I knew I would love it because these are totally my type of shades. I love that we have a large assortment of mattes as well as these amazing, like just richly molten metallic shades. They are incredible. So on my eyes today, I have Trust Fund, which almost feels kind of like a cream to powder in the pan. So that is the main shade that I have kind of in this first inner third of my eye. And then I kind of blended it out with a little bit of Fling, which in the pan, it looks more pink, but once it's on your eyes, it's like this gorgeous reddish pinky copper. So, so pretty. And then the mattes that I have on my eye today are Demure, Sandalwood, Henna, and Cocoa, as well as a little bit of Maneater on the outer corner. So even after using that many shades, nothing got muddy. These blend so nicely. They're so, so pigmented. You can go in and just have like the tiniest bit on your brush and start off with something really, really sheer if color really intimidates you, and then just gradually build it up, or you can just go in full force in the beginning and it still just blends out beautifully. Next up, we have the Urban Decay Beached Eyeshadow Palette. This one retails for $34 and this is a Ulta exclusive. So the packaging flips over all the way. It is cardboard. It's not like the tin packaging that you see in the Naked palettes. It does have a mirror, and inside you have 8 shades. Now, this is definitely a warm tone palette minus the 2 blues that you see in here. The only problem that I see, which isn't really like an actual problem, more of just personal preference, you only have 1 matte shade. So unless you have like other mattes in your eyeshadow collection, I don't quite know how you'll feel about this palette. It just feels like it's not like a fully complete palette. Now, if you're someone like me who is a makeup junkie and you have a ton of other eyeshadows, this won't be a problem at all. And the quality is so amazing. You know, sometimes with the Urban Decay palettes, for instance, some of the holiday palettes, it's just like not consistent with the typical Urban Decay quality. These are so richly pigmented, almost just like the Huda Beauty ones. Some of these metallics remind me more of like a foiled shadow. This one here, Wedge, the deepest shade, I mean, it's just such a gorgeous deep bronze. It almost gives your lids like this wet look. Heat Wave is another beautiful one. I mean, all of these shades are so beautiful. Check out Double Dip. This one, oh, this with just like a matte orange in your crease and then Plunge. Even if you just wanted to do like a warm toned eye and then have a pop of color on your lower lash line, these are such a pretty combination of colors. The pigmentation is definitely there, but like I said, if you don't have other mattes, that just may be one problem that you bump into. However, if you have the Urban Decay Naked Petite Heat, I feel like these are just almost made for each other, because in here you have all mattes. So if you were to use this and this side by side, you can definitely create a ton of like just gorgeous, rich, warm toned, beautiful, like summery sunset type of eyes. Plus with Double Dip and Plunge, you're still getting some sort of pop of color. Now, if you don't have the Naked Heat Petite, another very affordable option if you are just looking for more matte options to kind of coordinate with this palette is the Wet n Wild Not a Basic Peach. This matte brow bone color, as well as these gorgeous matte shades here. That way, if you're wanting to like deepen up your crease or your outer corner, these two work hand in hand as well. And this one I believe is like $4.99. And a lot of the times you can find Wet n Wild on sale. So that would be a more affordable option than the Naked Heat. Okay, moving on. The next palette is one that I personally would pass on, but I feel like all reviews in general are honestly personal preference. It just really kind of depends what kind of skin you have, what shades you prefer, what type of formula you prefer. But For me, this one just didn't really cut it. I normally love products from the Balm. I think they do have some great eyeshadow palettes, but this one was just kind of meh. It's called Foiled Again Foil Eyeshadow Palette. And I read foiled eyeshadow instantly. I'm like, oh my gosh, it's going to be like molten metallic wet eyelids. And this just didn't do it for me. I just found these to be kind of like standard metallic shades, especially after like the Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadows came out. Don't y'all remember those? Nobody talks about them anymore. It makes me really sad because I still love Makeup Geek, but those were just like so soft and just went on your lids, made your lids look wet. They were highly reflective. I just expected more. Like when I swatch them, they do still look pretty, but I use this probably I'd say 5 to 6 times the other week. And every time, eventually I just felt like my eye look kind of started to get muddy or just looked okay. It wasn't a look that I was ever like very proud of where I was like, oh my God, I love this. I can't wait to use it again. I did force myself to use it several times. That way I could go in with a different combination of colors. But every time I was just meh. Like it just wasn't anything that wowed me. Not something that I would have gone out and purchased myself. I did receive it as PR. While I totally appreciate the opportunity to try it, it just wasn't for me, I guess. Now, if you don't have many other eyeshadow palettes, it may be something that like excites you more, but there wasn't really any like standout colors in here that made it very unique to me. I wasn't blown away. I don't want to sound bratty, but I just wasn't that excited about it. It wasn't anything that, like I said, I was jumping at to use again and again. So yeah, there's that one. I always feel bad like saying that something was, but you know, there's so many products out there. They can't all be winners. Okay, next up we have a product from Mally Beauty. Honestly, I haven't tried too much from her line before. The packaging of this entire collection though is so, so cute. It's hot pink and then it's like actual little pieces of glitter. I mean, there's something on top of it that to where like the glitter doesn't rub off, but it's just so, so sparkly. I love it. Okay, so this palette is available at Ulta as well as mallybeauty.com. Inside you get 8 shades. This one retails for $29. Now, when I opened this, I was like, okay, those are colors that I like, but this one I kind of had to keep leaving out to remind myself to use because I don't know, I guess when it's a brand that I've seen a lot, but I've just never really used it, I wasn't that excited to use it, but I actually was pleasantly surprised. I will say though, these 2 shades up here, I wasn't that impressed with. I tried like packing them on with a wet brush. Fabulous wasn't awful, but Flirty, I thought that almost could have been changed out for like another matte option because it's just not a very impressive formula whatsoever. But Fierce, Passionate, and Loving, I really liked. Fierce is just this gorgeous, like metallic kind of golden bronze. Now, I feel like Passionate is misleading. That swatch isn't very impressive. My wrists aren't bruised. I was like swatching other lip products earlier, so they just look dirty and gross. But with the brush, you can really build up the pigmentation of Passionate. And I think sometimes formulas like that, whenever using one of those like burgundy shades, is actually a little bit better. That way you don't end up with like those sickly looking bruised eyes. If it's a shade that you can gradually build up, you're not having to go in like 12 times, maybe just like 2 to 3 times with your brush, you can really build it up just to kind of like smoke it out and blow it out in the crease. I was actually really happy with the look that I created that day. Loving is not a shadow I would recommend using with your brush. However, if you use your finger, how can you dip your finger in here? I mean, you can see the texture of it. To me, this is a true foiled shadow. I mean, you just have so much dimension in there, just the way that it gives that like wet metallic look. I love it. It is so, so pretty. Now, if you're more on like the fair, light to light medium color spectrum, you could definitely use Iconic as a contour powder as well because it is a very like cool toned, neutral type of brown. This shade does build up nicely on the crease as well. And Fearless is actually what I'm using as my highlighter today. So it is nice that you can use this eyeshadow palette as both an eyeshadow palette and then like contour and highlighter, but this in the inner corner and just on your cheekbones is so, so pretty. It's just a very light champagne type of gold. Okay, and then finally we have a palette from ColourPop. This is the Fame palette. Now, this is gonna be kind of sad for me to say because ColourPop is hands down one of my favorite eyeshadows of life. I have 2 massive palettes filled with nothing but ColourPop shadows. I absolutely love them. So the formula is still very consistent in this palette. I feel like ColourPop does a great job of always like matching the actual single shadow pan to like the palette. Sometimes when some companies like that create palettes, it's like the formula that's in the palette is just not the same. It's drier or chalkier. ColourPop pretty much always stays consistent. This palette retails for $22. You get 16 shades inside. Now, if you are a neutral, cool-toned lover, you will love this palette. When I look at this palette, I kind of see the Cool Tone Bride's Essential palette. You have very nice cool-toned neutrals, but my problem is I feel like a lot of the shades in here kind of start to look the same. You have lots of these like taupey, neutral, light silvers. I don't know. Whenever I used it, it was another one that I was just kind of like, yeah, okay. If you love cool tones, I think you would really get a ton of use out of this. And honestly, I probably shouldn't complain because I know sometimes people get so tired of seeing the same warm neutral palettes over and over again, which is totally understandable. Personally, if I wouldn't have received this one as PR, it's not one that I would have gone out of my way to purchase. I don't use a ton of cool tones, and a lot of these shades I feel like I already have in my collection. Now, if you don't have an extensive eyeshadow collection and you love cool tones, or you're just looking for a palette with a ton of everyday neutrals, this would be great for you. I can totally see why ColourPop did it. There are so many options for people who love warm tones. I'm sure people who only wear cool tones are like, what the hell is happening? Where's our color? So ColourPop did do a good job creating this. It's just not one that I was that excited for. So that is it for this video. I really hope you guys found it helpful. I would love to hear some of your more recent eyeshadow palette purchases down below, what you love about them, maybe what you hate about them. Hopefully you guys didn't end up with like too many dud products. But yeah, if you guys found this video helpful, definitely give me a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye.